I move for no man.
So be it!
Now stand aside, worthy adversary.
'Tis but a scratch.
A scratch? Your arm's off.
No, it isn't.
Well, what's that then?
I've heard worse.
You liar!
Come on, you pansy!
Victory is mine!
Still plenty of time to come and be served at the refreshment center before showtime.
Popcorn, rich with hot melted butter. Steaming hot coffee.
Hey everybody, it's Deluxicoff and it's Friday and we're playing my deck. Mathonical took this to just about every outing and placed almost every single time and won the entire event once. It's changed a very, very, very tiny bit thanks to him. Little mana tweaks here and there. I swapped the holdout settlements for survivor encampments because I like the art better. But other than that, everything's pretty much the same. I'll go over the list real quick. Good to see everybody. Shirazamon, Mike Mann, and the Polt in the house. If you're not chiming in, please do. We've got a wins card, Craig, two survivor encampments, two sanctuaries. I believe it's, five plains, four mountains. We changed to three gardens now, one forest, one wilds, one garrison, three sands, and three ash barrens. We got four bodyguards, four soul wardens, four souls attendant, two sins, four screech, four commune. Never side this out. This is the gas of the deck. Just, it's like a three or two, or sometimes a 4-4-1 in your favor. Standard bearer, four midnight, guard. It's a late night last night. Three prismatic strands, two rally of the peasants, and the presence of the gond. We have one Journey Nowhere on our sideboard, three Oblivion Rings, three Spider Silks over the four last time, three Archers to really shore up our matchups with Delver, Delver Red, etc. One Relic, and four Pyroblasts. So this today's going to be really weird. My brother's visiting, and I played three rounds already. I didn't quite know how today was going to go. I was about to cancel. I was like, no. So he's going to come in after I play the two live rounds and we'll replay stuff. And then the, competitive side, whatever, will be over. And then it'll be kind of fun to poke fun at my brother. He'll show up, try to play Magic. He knows what the cards are and he knows there's creatures and a little bit about mana. And that's it. There was no primer. So he's probably going to drop pretty hard, and it'll be just be fun to watch them screw up, and hopefully, if not, big deal. It's a one-off show, so we shall see. Anyway, that's awesome art. Give this list in paper. All right, so like I said, it's kind of like the way I used to do it, where I'd done rounds before, and I've been running real hot with this. I had a 5-0 and then a 4-1, and I can't quite remember what I lost to. I don't have the notes, but we've already beaten Affinity, Delver, and Elves. The Elves matchups was interesting, though, because they really had it if just because of the life gain, they could have timed me out. But I think, Jason Moore, I believe, on Pure MTGO, I was just saying he wrote one of his better articles of all time about just the Art of War sort of angle with Magic the Gathering and taking the will out of your opponent. And boy, does this deck do it when you start making infinite tokens and, gaining horrific amounts of life. So the Pult says, as someone who hasn't played the exact list before, the mana base looks all over the place. You couldn't be further from the truth, the Pult. It was pretty close before. Mathonical is a hardcore mathematics guy. He's got spreadsheets up the wazoo, has all these hypergenic calculators, gets things down to like the 0.00 decimal place of how things draw. And hopefully this represents it. I've seen nothing but it lately. It's like I almost have access to all three colors every single opening hand. It's ridiculous. It's really, really enlightening to see math work, you know. So he was really shocked that I was able to get this close just on hunches and just sheer deck design. What would you call it? Totalitarian, like just doing it so much that I got actually within a few decimal spots of it being correct, but could always use some help, and boy, has it helped. And I've just been, yes, because of maths. And we will be playing that. Quick aside, my brother, we like to call him the chalk boss. It's a really long story, but he got me into horror. He was kind of my dad growing up too, about an 8-year difference. He's older than I am. And always kind of raised me on horror movies and stuff in a good way. And we grew up in a really cool horror-esque sort of Friday the 13th looking lake. It's so, you know, the whole theme today, I've got a little bit darker stuff. He really likes the maths thing. So it's kind of just an homage to my older brother who's in town visiting and seeing the sights and that sort of thing. So, yeah, results, I would have played, I think the very first challenge I played Midnight Gond and... or Rally Gone, or whatever you want to call it. And I broke even, but I had a bug that cost me from placing probably in the top 20. But Methonical is really consistently, he had 1 week off and has been going. And man, this opponent's taking forever to show up. But anyway, he's been like in the top 15 almost every single time, and like one of one player a lot of times. But I will not sugarcoat this. This is a very hard deck to play right. And it's not so much what you need to do when. It's kind of a style thing, just like how I always kind of am down on myself about how I'm not a good teachings player, or it's just more of a style thing that you got to get down. All right, let's see if I can get this going here. Boom, 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 boom. So we've got our mana looks pretty good here. Let me just look at it real quick. Yeah, so we've got what we need here. We'll keep this. Yeah, my oldest is at yet another basketball tournament in Vegas, so anyway. Okay, looks like Stompy. We shall see. So we only need one card now to hit our combo. What I've been finding, what's really fun to do, especially against Delver and decks that can answer the presence combo, is you just side it out, because we have so much hate against the standard decks like that. It's funny how long I've been playing Tribe. I get really nervous when I see a Vault Scourge with Lifelink, because I know I've only got like 3 swings and I got to find my combo, but I'll have to chill out, because this deck can come back from anything if it draws okay. Prismatic Strands is really MVP in this matchup, but don't really like seeing the Scourge out right away because it represents a different color, and if he starts bringing out the big stuff, we'll be in some pain, a pain game. Okay, well, this will go a long way. We're going to go get ourselves a white. Watch, I'll get mana screwed. And I think somebody was mentioning that mono black outing that we had the other day on YouTube. Somebody was saying, like, you know, did you realize, like, this really rare thing happened every single game? And it's like, looking back, I'm like, yeah, that's right. It did. It was very ridiculous how biased the card draw engine was that day. But, hey, it happened, so... What's going on? Little fights in the house. Yep, yep. So, we only got 2 live rounds today, and then I'll review, and that's just going to be kind of a fun powwow. I don't know how long my brother's going to last. He might get real frustrated after one game. We'll pull the plug. Who knows? But, okay, well, that's going down. Okay. We don't draw something good here. This could be a quick one. All right. Well, that's good. I think it better to drop the commune here. So we might get prismatic. Oh, that's pretty good. I mean, we have to choose the standard bearer, but it would have been nice to get one of those 4 lands, but we'll go from there. Drop this. I was really hoping to get prismatic in the yard if something goes crazy. Drawing a little bit slow here. Might lose this first one. If any deck, though, this one, boy, it can come back from the grave so just amazingly. Yeah, I don't think we're going to survive this. Got 7 coming through. I can't block any of it. Now a Battle Screech would be nice. But without the standard bear out there, it's only going to buy us like 1 turn. Got our combo. Now, before you say you should have played this first, remember that we... drew four, shuffled, and did all that stuff, so that scenario wouldn't have come through. So before we really kind of show our cards here, I mean, I'm pretty sure he knows what we got, but yeah, we're dead here. Stumpy. So funny, playing solo, I'm like, I think 14-1 in the last three outings with this. Here I go with this. All right. I wonder if that list runs gut shot. I'm going to lose a Gond. Bring in a Journey. Tempted to bring in a Spider Soap. I'm going to bring in one of those. Lose one Gond. One of these. And I'm just going to bring in one Ring just for kind of a catch-all last-minute creature. Bit Sulk, that sort of thing. So we only got two, three. Can guard with the Midnight Guard. Go from there. Let me go over the list real quick, make sure. Sense Enlistment might be able to go out, but boy, I really like when I get that life engine going. All right. And I believe that's it. It's not coffee this morning. It's Blue Moon beer, so hey, maybe that's why I lost, right? Yeah, yeah. About a week into my vacation, or staycation, I should say. Having a good old time. Yowza. Let's go here. Yes. No mana. Wow, 23 lands and nothing. Oh, that's an easy mulligan. One mana. Guys, sensing a theme here. I swear, there's some ghost in the machine when I'm live. This is nuts. And we've got the combo, but we can't keep this. Got a mulligan. Good grief, mulligan. This is ridiculous. Keep. Oh, boy. I'm going to put this on top just because we're probably going to need as much life as we can if we're going to come back from a draw like this. Crazy. All right. This time I will do this. I think we're going to lose to Stompy here. This is ridiculous. Usually a pretty easy matchup. Well, that's a good sign. Gain some life. Always yes, always yield. Stack automatically. Drop this. I mean, even if you don't like me, you've got to admit that NBC outing, the hands there and the hands so far here, pretty crazy. Especially given the math behind it and all the other successes I've had with it, where it's like, that never happens, but for some reason, live on Twitch, it sure seems to. Got to trust the math will work out eventually. Alrighty, so he kills our dude. Yuck. Well, I can block that all day long, but I don't really, I want to buy as much time as I can, so I'm actually just going to Journey right now. Just got a Vines, anything like that. Try to save as much tempo as possible, because we're almost hellbent already, stuck at two lands, need our combo, need just about everything. Can commune with the gods would be great here. Got the card. That's good times. I'll cycle this. Go grab our mountain. Make them fear that we got some direct damage trick, which we don't. Coming on in. Got 24 land. A little stultified there, but what are you going to do? Hoo-ah. Breakfast beer, says Shirazaman. It's afternoon. Look at this. Yeah, I've got, boy, I tell you what, this little cloud cover thing going on here took forever. What happened was I had a cloud environment and it had audio, and then when I brought it into After Effects, it exported with audio, and then when I told it to loop, the mic heard the loop, started looping the audio, and it was a recursion loop, and it fed on itself, and it took me forever to figure out what was going wrong. It drove me nuts. All right. Boy, I tell you what. This was the first time playing this deck. I'd be like, boy, this needs work, but I know it doesn't. I mean, I've had so much success with this personally recently in the past, and I know Mathonical's had nothing but it too, but look at this. Just, oh my goodness. Well, this is kind of good for the deck, though, because Mathonical and I are always kind of joking, like, I truly think this is one of the best decks in Pauper that just nobody plays it. I think it's really click intensive, and it takes quite a bit to learn it, but It's like, this is not a good advertisement for it. Kind of a good thing. At this point, it's like, please. What a strange play. Oh, okay. That makes sense. Got about a four-turn clock. Nothing else goes right. Okay, well, I'll try to get some bodies going here. We are hellbent. Should have like prismatic strands in the yard and critters going down, but what did we mull to? Four, I think. That was brutal. But if any deck can survive it, it's probably going to be this one. Might as well. Hate that it has trample. Be nice to get our dudes out. We could at least have a rally the peasants in the sideboard. I got a sense that this guy overboarded. A really slow start for Stompy. We should be in a lot bigger trouble right now. I mean, a 7-5 is nothing to sneeze at, but he's getting a little bit flooded too. So at least the cruel calculator is being mean to both of us. It's just it's been mean to me twice. And if you're online, you know, get ready to... play my brother if you want to. Challenge him up. And what deck do you want to see him play? Because I've been kind of torn. I don't want to throw something that has way too many clicking because he's very new to the concept of even playing online. I think he's played on paper like 10 years ago. I showed him one game, like little vanilla decks and stuff. So I was trying to think like he's really fond of the Jess guy. He just likes that name. It cracks him up for some reason. So I don't know what that's all about. All right. Seven gets me one, that gets me none. Well, here's the deal. I could wait for the Gond. That could technically be playing the outs. If we draw prismatic strands, we might be able to pull off something. But if we draw a Rally Gond, that would be 2, 4, 6, 8. Yeah, I can't really flash it back. I don't know. I think I hold on to it here. Seven, block for three. Actually, if we play it and make... This is rough. Killer Tofu's in the house! All right. That would be 3, 4, 5. If we draw another creature after that, we can block with everything and kill, but he's probably got pump, so I'm just going to hold on and swing. Except that 7 plus the most common thing like vines or a giant, I mean, you know, the force spell. I think I'm going to attack with 2 and keep one back to block with. Go from there. I'm pretty sure we're going to lose this one. Replays all, it's pretty fun games though. I apologize. It's not going to be a new thing again. I just, I had 3 games in, and before I knew it, it was Friday, and brother was joking around about being on, so we're going to block here. I know I could turn on Hunger, but the probability that he has Vines or Groundswell or something like that is quite a bit higher, especially since one Hunger's already in the yard. There's 5. Okay, moment of truth. Well, that doesn't really help us, does it? Yeah, we fold this one up. I don't see a way of winning this. I mean, we could kill it with the rally, but when you mold a 4, it's pretty brutal. All right. Well, I'm just going to fold it up here. Let me just look real quick. 2, 3, make a creature. 5 would still get through. Yeah, not like it bounces that, so. Looks like he's holding a pan flute. A little bit. Yeah, the little goatee there. Does look like that. Well, not something that happens often. The Stompy loss, but it was. Boom, boom. First one a little more warranted than the second. That was just atrocious draws there. So hopefully the next game will make up for that, and we'll see a little bit of the... match 1, I was 2-0 against Affinity. Delver, I was 2-0, and then Elves, I was 2-0, and then, as we saw just now, Crash and Burn Hard against Stumpy, which usually isn't a thing. Like any deck, if they have the nuts and they go crazy and you hiccup at all, that can happen, as noted there. But Mulligan in the Forest, pretty burly. Yeah, it does look like the Shire, doesn't it, Shiraz? Like some sort of a, I don't know, like a hobbit sort of build. They're awfully strange little creatures. Gifkin's got some pretty neat cards. There's a lot of unblockable tricks and stuff like that. It'd be neat if they go that way. All right. Dun, bum, bum. Hopefully it doesn't take as long as the last time did. My goodness, that was a... Oops, here we are. So yeah, a lot of times against Delver and such, I've been citing out the combo because we have Pyroblast, we have Scattershot, what do you call, Spider Silk Armor. And when you add all those up, you just kind of have like this overkill game against them as opposed to playing, you know, the traditional combo thing. Because, you know, with the Vapor Snag and the response and being able to do stuff. Against non-interactive decks, it's great to just keep the combo in, maybe lose one or two parts of it, but... It's neat. It's similar to Tribe, where the threat of that combo is so like intimidating that people just, you know, they kind of overboard and slow their roll, and allow you to just kind of do a little bit of the side game there. Whoop! Well, this is weird. Strange how that happens. Hey, get over there, you little. Gonna be. I promise this is not the beer. This is the machine. All right. Yes, we would like to play first. This is probably the first time I've ever seen this happen. Double bounce. Let's mulligan. Okay. Okay, hand. Not the greatest, but we'll keep it as mean as this thing's been going on. This is a tough call. I'll probably put it on top. Roll from here. Drop this past the turn and we'll see. As I recall, the older Gonless played Lumer Third Field instead of Spider Sick. Was the change due to Delver? I never don't believe I had any lists with it. I think the Spider Silk was superior in most ways, but I know there was I'm not sure. I can't recall that, Napolt. Alrighty. Well, that's not as good as it was, is it? Black. I'm going to get out stuff quicker than later. Let me bring out the bodyguard first. This order seems a little weird, but I already got edict insurance. Wants to wipe something of that. That's all right. We'll at least be able to buy the standard bear two turns and turn it on a little bit against a deck it's not that good against. I don't have many games against if this is mono black. Indeed, it seems like it with two of those. So I will favor the garden play here. Boom, boom. Drop this. Sanctuary is going to pay a lot of dues because I believe this is mono black. So we'll have something that can eat an edict. Bit of a slow roll here. Might want to keep that bodyguard back in case our combo does show up. Be able to protect it, but all right. The gallery of removal continues. I'm going to commune right now. What are we going to throw in the yard? Well, Battle Screech will go in the yard, but we're going to take the Gond. We will play this. And this. Bring out Gond with a little bit of backup next turn. Too bad these weren't white, or we could flash back the Battle Screech in the yard. Rally is in the graveyard, and so is Battle Screech, so... The long night and its many victims, says McMahon. Yeah, this is so much better than Holdout Settlement. Being a desert's nice too, but... Wish I had a shuffle effect there, but we'll be all right. Drop here. Drop this. Got some backup. Pass the turn. And hope we draw something good. Another white creature would be very nice. Hopefully he's just stuck on a bunch of edict effects. We'll see. If not, we got the bodyguard. Yeah, the desert and the art just put it over the top. I've never been a fan of Holdout Settlement's art. The Zendikons are just something I'm not too fond of seeing. And he's time-walking himself. I could respond to this, but then he's just going to eat a plant token, so I'll wait till he actually targets it and then make it safe. I know it'll turn on Gary a little bit more, but what you going to do? I'll say black. And something relevant, please. Of course, that keeps our battle screech from going on online anytime soon. Let us do this. I'll cycle here for the red source just because we got plenty of white. Drop this. Play this. If he's got another rat, we will use it. You know, he's got bog. It might be interesting to play the rally here. 4, 6, 8. I believe I will attack. All right. So yeah, go easy on my brother. He's not the gamer. I got all that gene by far, and so I think sometimes he gets a little burned out when he visits, and I can kind of overdo the whole gaming side of things, but you can always play rally as a defensive play too. I've wiped the board a few times. Is the right move to do on, you know, defense, and everybody's attacking you and you got a bunch of really strong looking plants. Flaxia. Write this down real quick. MBC. Coming on in. Or is he? Okay. We'll go from there. Okay, well, I like to draw this. Commune. Well, there's Presence of the Gond. He's got two up. What do you think? We should go for it? You know, by itself, the Midnight Guard's it's a pretty, pretty great little card. If I take Presence of the Gond, he's going to kind of have to be forced to slow roll. Like if he drops Gary next turn, it's just over because I'll bring that out and go for it. But I don't think I'm going to go for it quite yet. I think I'll keep Prismatic up. Two mana, it's too much goods there. Hopefully he's got damage base removal and that Prismatic will actually do something, but I'm gonna slow roll this a little bit. Whenever I play the deck with Rally, says the Pult, it feels like my opponent is always surprised to see my army of small creatures wins game. Yeah, the majority of the time the deck does win off of Rally and just that surprise swing, because boy, those numbers sure add up fast. It's just neat. You get them, like I said, they're just so, like, I don't know if afraid's the right word. They're just, okay. There's that. The echoing. Yikes. Okay. Darn it. So we've only got one more guard in the deck. I'd rather have strands in my yard than in hand, so I'm just going to tempo the turn out here. Stay pure. Say black. Pass and hope we get something good. How funny would it be to drop the very next guard, right? Well, here's a thing. I'll go here. Now, that's not worth dropping the gun, but boy, if he's got another rats, it's gonna feel terrible. Okay. Prismatic strands is turned on. One of the main reasons I designed the deck this way, it doesn't run the convoke green creatures and such, is so that you have the ability to flash these things back. All right, well, that's dead. This is going to be really shocking if this goes 0-2 when I'm sitting here winning outside of Twitch all the time with it, but it could happen. I don't see mono black all that often, so I'm going to feel like a fool if all he had was this sorcery spell removal, because the decay wouldn't have done it. It's pretty hard with two up against black to throw your combo into the wind like that, I think, anyway. This stage, I don't really want Gary to hit me for much more than this. He's almost at chainer math with, two in the yard. I might consider dropping the very next thing is going to be able to take that out. I might consider taking the rally out and blocking and at least killing the chittering, saving me about 4 to 6 to 8 damage, maybe. So, I mean, we're kind of up against it here. Now, if this made white plant tokens, that would be pretty cool. Yeah, first I'm going to make sure to block. So if he does have something, he's got to do something with it. But just playing my outs here. Oops, that requires red. It's about a 0.5 for one. Really don't want to get eaten up by Gary, because that would be a turn 2 clock if that came down next turn. It helps a little bit. Buys another turn. I'll have 2 strands in the yard. I had one version with 4 of these. It was just a little bit too much. I mean, if you know you're just going to see Stompy all day, then it's a good call. But so I guess that one, right? We definitely, well, we'd be at 14. This would be 2, 4, 6, 7. Yeah, it would have been a two-turn clock. Three cards in our opponent's hand. I think we're going to lose this first game. Don't see much coming back from this, especially if he's got another Gary. Well, a little edict insurance. What's going to be really funny is if I go 0-2 live and my brother comes in and you guys steer him to a victory. That'd be pretty funny. This isn't white. I don't know really anything. I'm just going to block it. See a lot more scenarios where I die not blocking than when I do. Yeah, it would be pretty cool. Yep. All right. Down against black. Got to win the next 2 straight. Got a pretty good deck against us. We're trying to do creatures. He's got a way to remove them all. Not quite sure of our opponent's list here. But I know what I'd bring in. And so I'm going to bring in 2 spider silks. I'm going to lose the bearers as our first move. Prismatic strands isn't that relevant against mono black. For now, I'm going to lose one of those. 1 gond. We all know that black is really bad at removing enchantments. So if he has an obulate on our part of our combo, we'd want to be able to get rid of that. So I'm going to bring in 2 oblivion rings. And I think this is looking good. Yeah. Unless anybody's got any critique, I'll punch yourself in the face now. I know, did I say something to the effect like I'll punch myself if this thing loses even 2 in a row? And I don't, if this is the very first weekend, I don't think I'm going to be able to participate in the challenge. All the family's coming back on Sunday, I believe. If I got that wrong, then I will play it. But plus my brother's here, and playing for an hour or 2 live is way different than 6 or 7 on a long Sunday. So I'm all geared up to play this because I've been, like I was saying, having a bunch of 4-1s and 1-5-0 out of, 3 outings. So, 2 outings. So kind of feeling it again. Finally got Tireless Tribe out of my system a little bit. It's like an old girlfriend or something. We didn't reveal the combo there, Mike Man, but I'm pretty sure a person have to be kind of living under a rock. And even if they were, it's an old enough combo. I think they're probably still pretty used to it. We shall see. Apologies for Magic trying to shove my auto screen all over the place. Deluxe, Argentina. Thank you for that, Valaxia. Hopefully you see this later and see my apologies, because if I type to you, the feed will go all crazy. Yes, I would like to play first. Okay, good looking hand. Got part of our combo. We got answers for Obelite if that gets disrupted, so we'll keep this. Only thing I don't like, I'd like this to be a mix-up of the Soul Sister so Echoing Decay doesn't wipe them both out, but hey, with how we drew last game, I'm happy to see a land I can keep at six. He saw Presence of Gone off in the commune, I think. I believe you're right. Yeah, you are. That's right. And I'm still not done playing Mono Black. I really, really like that deck. That's a fun one. Well, I got to play true to my form. I'm going to drop both these girls, and I'm going to feel like an absolute fool if he's got Echoing Decay main. As he very well might. We saw it in game one. And I also know that there's Edicts, lots of other removal, and there's many more ways to win the game here than hoping that he has one of, or maybe one of 60 or two of yield. Yes. Stack abilities automatically. And let's attack. Any creatures. A nice healing solve effect, which is very nice. Plus, black's usually about three or four turns in before it really gets any defenders out. Unless he's got witches. That would suck. Hey, there she is. And if we draw the most probable thing, land, we'll for surely have a target. Play very slow when you see witches. You can end up killing a lot of your own stuff. Ugh, what a kick in the crotch. Look at that. Got the answer. Don't have the mana this time. Flooded last time. Oh, well. At least this will result in one ping. Soul Triplets. Sounds like a good band. Here's where you got to be real careful, because you want to save your creature or click on it half the time and you end up killing it. The way that's worded is cruel indeed. So that kind of denotes that he doesn't have Decay in hand. That definitely, we know he doesn't have Decay in hand. A little bit of a slow roll, but all of a sudden we're at one creature. All right, let's make a green. How do we make green, you might say? We go like this. Bring this out. Black really hates enchantments. Now I turn that lady off. That way if our battle screech goes live, we can at least do something with it. Or the Soul Sister will at least ask for a real removal spell instead of the witches pinging her all day. Some things never change. You want to beat black or red, you bring in enchantments usually. So long as they're good enchantments. I will not lie. If I go 0-2 live with this after going having so many nice outings with it, it's going to be a little embarrassing. Okay. Sins Enlistment's very nice. I like to see that, but I'm going to drop this just to get rid of the blocker. Let's say I have another one. Of course, if he kills it in response, I'll have to eat my own soul. Eat my own soul. Devong, it's gone. The idea to get Presence of God. Oh, I didn't see the question. Devon, good to see you. New to this deck, not sure what we are doing. Well, from the results, I'm not either. Now, this is a Gond has been around for a long time, and it was usually built with green convoke creatures. And not to pat my own self on the back, but this is probably the best innovation I've come up with in about a decade, where I completely overhauled it, made it about white creatures, flying, defensive abilities of prismatic strands and such, and turned on a really cool little engine that has a few different lines of attack. Oh, we lost our critter to be able to pull that off. Yikes. Now it's feeling clunky. Survivor's Encampment isn't that good without a creature out. But its ability to just toy with the graveyard, go find the answers to the combo. Oh my god, this is just getting brutal. All right. I don't want him to make me discard that. If he's got another chittering after this, I'm going to be so depressed. Let's see. No chittering, no chittering. No kick in the crotch. And Devon, I am sure I like you because you're from Argentina. Not to sound like a countryist, is that a word? I've met like four people from Argentina, and they were just four of the coolest people I've ever met. So I'm a bit biased. I think all Argentinians are awesome. But yeah, like I said, I can't quite type much with this. This is all right. We got 24 life. So we're going to drop green here. Go, hopefully grab something. Not all land. Of course, we throw away four lands. We need one more land to really kind of start becoming relevant. It's one of those days, I tell you. Sins, enlistment. Yes, that's our kind of engine of choice. It allows us to really smooth out our mana early, and then later on, as we all know how much I love Retrace, we're able to turn on the ability and save our skin. Trespasser's Curse. Wow, that's some great tech against us. Whenever a creature enters the battlefield under enchanted player's controls, that player loses one life and you gain a life. That is going to be a problem. We've got to get a Soul Sister online and negate that. Otherwise, that's really good tech against us. It's nice to see somebody playing that. I've been trying to make a few decks around that. It's just one of those I can't quite find the right deck for it. But it's nice to see it. Okay. Well, we've got black now. Darn it. I wish I had two critters up. It's the clunkiest few turns I've ever seen with this. God, I hope there's not another chittering rats. It's ridiculous. Yes, there's the kick in the crotch. Well, we get one of our soul sisters out. It'll negate that enough time to pull off everything. But if we keep getting rat chitteringed, we're going to be in a real deep trouble here. All right, that's dead. Strange leaving in chainers against a deck that has so much. I'm just going to bust this now. I know you should wait till they tap, but don't have any real instant creatures, so pull that off. And hope for the best. No chittering, no chittering. All right. Well, there's that. The way this fell, that's kind of funny. We kind of have to go get a white with it. Isn't that strange? White. Go like this, pass the turn. No chittering, but now at least we can... Let's see what the smartest thing to do is. Probably one sends there, one in the hand. I'm going to take nine. Definitely want to block next turn. I would love to sends and... He'll probably take out the chittering rat. Ooh, good grief. We're going to lose this one because of that curse, too. There's not many ways around this, guys. I mean, we've got our ladies. This is a loss of life. I mean, we can prismatic next turn. Then if we... So the only way we really can do anything is if we draw... like a soul sister next turn. Otherwise, I will be going 0-2 live after 5-0, a 4-1, and this one started with a 3-0. That's what makes the game we all know and love, right? These crazy scenarios, but nothing against our opponent. Ow, 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 ow. Hold on here. I've got something to say about that. Let's at least have one more turn, please. This has got our number with no help of our own deck, that's for sure. This is Captain Kick in the Crotch. Oh, no, we're already 3-1 right now, the Polt. I did, this is going to do it. I did three rounds live, which we'll go over next. show you guys, but I'd be happy to play one of you live too if you want to. I'm always surprised how fast this deck plays out in wins and in losses. But so Valaxia kicked our crotch, that's for sure. So yeah, we win this one at 3-2. Unfortunately, both losing rounds were live, but let me show you the replays here. Okay, yes, I see. So match one was against Affinity, and I'm gonna just try to play game twos because it's after the sideboard tech comes in and such. We'll go up from here. This reminds me of the old days when I first did Pauperganda. For about the first 4 or 5 months, I would do this where I'd play two or three rounds live, depending on how long the deck was, and then I'd replay the other odds. So I'll try to hover over the pause button here. So our opening hand, we keep this. We've got a Garden Sands, two Barrens, and a Wilds, and a part of our combo in the Battle Screech. So we drop our little lady next turn. Out comes the Furnace. Pretty sure we're going to get bit. But what you going to do? Gain some life. Coming out with the Soul's Attendant. And opponent sticks a Prism. Affinity's a little behind on the curve as far as time it takes to get things assembled, but just trying to get my mana right. It's very right, very early. And Clark Can Shaman, something we don't want to see here. You never really want to see a Tog very much either, but hey, it'll happen. It's tough when you play these replays because you have such a Pavlovian response to like, and it's like, oh, you got to keep reminding yourself this is live. So, okay, I'm going to slow it down a little bit here so you guys don't get lost what's going on here. Because that looked fast to me, and I played the deck. I made the deck. Three Battle Screeches went in the yard and Ascends Enlistment. Optimally here is when Prismatic Strands goes in the yard, and boy, that really catches people off when they don't see it played the first time. Sometimes they can go all in and go for it. But we chose to keep the journey, and out it comes. So we're going to hit play and go from here. Eat this Atog, swing for two, and block with the plant. Yeah, we're going to see my brother. This is actually going to be probably a pure defeatist screen just because he's almost never played Pauper before. So that'll be interesting to see. So we got three sisters online. Out comes Battle Screech. Gain horrific amounts of life. Flash him back with the ladies. And it comes. Got our plant token. Got the other one in there. And now, as you can see, if we do have Rally the Peasants, this is when it just gets absurd. So always respect the Atog. Still probably get there. This is nice. Standard Bear might look kind of weird against this deck right now. But if you think about it, if he's got Fling, Galvanic Blast to protect it from that, it's pretty organic to the deck. So I'll play your brother with one of my silly brews, his little fight. That'd be pretty cool. Yeah, maybe he can beat you on time. I'll be here helping them, telling them when to click. I think when I first show people how to play online, the biggest thing they miss is that it's always asking you, okay, click okay, click okay. As we know from experience, they always have the blast, says the pull. Yes, indeed. So that was the second game against Affinity. I'll roll to second round. I faced Delver, which we all know I like to design decks that beat that to no avail. And I believe both of these matches were just like pretty crazy. I'll play the second one here because I believe it was this one that went crazy. One of them was just like one of the, I think it was this tournament. They're all running together now, so we have to scoop mold the five and up keeping this. Okay, so we've got our hate card against their hate cards. Hopefully this doesn't flip. Again, I can't remember. This was about a day ago I played this. It flips, showing Counterspell in their hand. So I think bluff there to get it through for the Archer. Sometimes it's nice against these builds to overpay for something. I'm going to try to, I believe I try to make them bite on the Prismatic here. I want to catch people being counter happy. Days, not what we wanted to see, but it can happen. I was really hoping they were going to counter that, but we'll see. Go from here. We drop another Archer. Strange to counter that, but I guess, yeah, we can turn off the Delver. So now it's like, okay, I'm going to pause it here. We know we win this one, but I'm at, you know, I'm like one swing away from death here. It's 20-6. Doesn't seem that good, but we know we got rid of his counterspell, so we drop our Life Lady. We've got Prismatic. And this sticks, so it's kind of like enter our cue sound effect for whatever needs doing there. I play here, he plays Snap. I cast Prismatic Strands. Calling Blue, nice new Snap artwork. Take out the Delver. And now the game starts looking very winnable. We have a Prismatic Strands in the yard again, which isn't that good against Spire Golem, but it's good against the rest of the deck. Anything else that drops, we can kind of rip out of the sky, and we've got this crazy life package that's going to gain us more life than anything. And it's kind of silly when Ninja comes down and you've got access to the Scattershot, because just its back plays, what do you call it? I'm going to say Rut Shot. Is that the word I'm looking for? Remember, we were at 6, and then all of a sudden, and we love when they counterspell that. Just sit back, pick stuff out of the sky. Probably shouldn't have done that. Probably should have waited to block the ninja. But I think I was planning on killing the ninja and hopefully drawing a counterspell out of their hand. And he doesn't draw any cards in this scenario, but he loses a ninja and great amounts of tempo. It's kind of neat to see this play out fast like this, but... So he is hell-bent, so I kind of go for broke here with this. Pull this off, bring him to 16. He rolls through, we let him draw the card. And it's back to ours. Battle Screech, really going to shut the door here. We'll flash it back, and then we just swing for the win next turn outside of a counterspell. Got one card in hand, got a blocker for pretty much everything. And we block here. I just play it to see it. It's fun to cast that as a sorcery often to see, you know, is it worth attacking now, as opposed to kind of going all in with your army and seeing if you can get there. But so there's technically how the deck usually works in that scenario with Delver, which can, you know, just like all the top decks we saw against Stomp. I was surprised we lost to Mono Black, but again, I don't have much experience playing against that. And finally, our third matchup was against Elves. Now, you'll notice this guy had the win, and I think it was the first game. I'll play both of these because this was a telling thing. I probably shouldn't do this because he'll know this now, but it really speaks to kind of taking the wind out of somebody's sails. I'm not happy to see Elves. I mean, the Standard Bear is nice because he has to target it with the Timber Watch, so it gives our deck a lot of longevity, but he had an early life, as did we. And I think once the combo showed up, he just was like, oh, this is over. And it's like, well, it really isn't if once you see the board state. Oh, the bad matchups were gone. I'm sorry I missed that, the poll. I would suggest that it's probably some Tron variant. Sometimes really heavy blue-red control builds are tough because if they know how to play against it, they'll pick apart things they need to, draw the cards. You've all been there. That can happen, but it's an incredibly powerful deck. I mean, it's kind of like a Naya best of, and so when you think about it that way, the opponent needs to have the deck that can beat you, and you need to draw bad, as we just saw against the last two live rounds. So, I mean, if we look at the scenario here, he's pretty much got infinite life to tie us up with infinite life, and okay, I've got him a little bit on time, but this is a really intriguing matchup, especially game one. I was pretty sure I was going to lose this one because I don't really have any ways outside of my sideboard to really kind of pick up the problems with the Well-Wisher there. So, you know, if this becomes really popular, I could see, you know, adding a Holy Light to this build, which would kind of eviscerate their side of the board. But yeah, they've got the life, do all this stuff. Vanguard's relevant. I'm not going to minimize the cards just because I don't want to reset this. We all see what's going on. And out come our dudes. Our dudes versus their dudes. Another Timber Watch. Thank God Standard Bear's in here. I mean, this would have been over like 5 turns ago. Midnight Guard shows up. We got a nice fat blocker now. His Vanguard's only a 2-2, and he is hell-bent. I was hoping my only out here, I didn't think I was going to beat him or he would concede. I was hoping that he would draw Distant Melody and deck himself, and I'd be able to stay enough ahead on life that I'd be able to, you know, keep the game within my reach. But so commune comes down, we grab another life creature, and we start swinging, playing the intimidation game here. We take out his army here, whack. Gains a bunch of life with the elf. Now the board looks a lot more favorable. But it was kind of a, you know, it wasn't that bad of a move with the standard bearer out there. I know the person probably thinks like, oh, this is over. But so here's the psychological warfare. I'm going to pause it here because when we play this card, let's look at the board state. Okay, he's at 88 life, double R's, and can keep doing it. I mean, the Quarian Ranger can't activate this because it's got to choose the Ranger. But look what this makes. These make elf tokens. So there's really no way for me to win here. I don't have Journey Main or anything like that. It's 20 minutes to 21. I've got them just by about 50 seconds. It's a very winnable board position here, but the psychological like ability for that just to like, okay, look at this. I'm going to gain two life every single time this happens, and I can do it an infinite amount of times. And he quits. So I think that was a bit of an error. I got a little bit lucky on that one. So we'll see that. I'll play you the second game of that one because it's a little bit more honest. I think that one, not that I was being dishonest or he was, I just a strange choice of words there. But I really think, like I showed you, I think the opponent had that if they would have focused there. But making elf tokens is great unless they are gaining life with elf tokens, which kind of keep everything the same. Anyway, so this is the second game against elves. Kind of got a slow, bit of a slow hand, but brought in Oblivion Ring to just take care of problem critters. Already got our combo in hand. This one happens pretty fast, so I wanted to show you the first one. Sometimes you just got it, and then this deck feels horribly unfair. Mana's all right. I know it does look all over the place, but for the most part, I think if you play 10 games with it, you'll have 9 where you're like, wow, this mana really works, and then there's going to be one where you're like, ugh. And if you are endeavoring to make a deck that is 3 colors, make sure you're not trying to make it even colors. I mean by that, you know, make sure that you have, and I believe this is just the ultimate turn 4 play, right? We put a creature down that can gain life, and then we set up our infinite combo just in time because even if he didn't drop another elf, that would be 2, 4, 5, yeah, 50. Yeah, if he swung with everything, we'd be toast. So, but if you are trying to make this, you know, the only reason this red's run is that 2 cards that can flash back late in the game. So having a curve like that, it's really a 2-color deck that can, you know, splashes red for very late game stuff. Just make sure if you're wondering how this combo works, this is how it works. Our opponent conceded, but Midnight Guard says create a 1/1, excuse me, whenever another creature enters the battlefield, untap Midnight Guard. And then you put Gond on it, and it says, tap this, create a 1/1 creature, which triggers this that says, untap it. And then you do it back, forth, and you can make as many tokens as your heart desires. Anyway, it is time. I'm going to get my brother, roll to a commercial or 3, and please be nice to him. If I'll have the list on the upload later for this, but very laissez-faire day today, just kind of having fun. There'll be quite a bit of giggling, private jokes and stuff like that, but let him know what deck you want to play and such, and we'll be back in just a few with my brother, Donald. We'll see you soon.
Guys, Cody and the gang are at the park playing football with downtown Darius Jackson.
Let's go!
You're not going anywhere without your big game liquid slam.
Excellent!
Go long. This one's going downtown. Whoa!
Whoa! Yeah! Now I got a full team.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Liquid Slam!
Liquid Slam! Oh!
tough day, kids? Well, I've got just the thing. How about some big game pizza pigskins?
Awesome!
Yeah!
Yeah.
Hungry got me in a grapple. Big game pizza pigskins is my hunger that you tackle. All day, every day, big
touchdown,
game.
Mrs. D.
Big game pizza pigskins for your taste, but the touchdown.
Big game pizza pigskins. Pizza that tastes better on a football.
Always use a flamethrower with adult supervision.
Deluxicoff's Wild Mongrel Bubblegum. Blows colored bubbles. Changes colors while you chew. Discard your old brand for something new.
Deluxicoff's Wild Mongrel Bubblegum. It's yummy.
Clogged pipes and plugged up toilets can bring a busy family to its knees. At Stinkweed, we know and understand you and your family just don't have time for that. Stinkweed, fast, professional plumbing you can count on. Call 2-in-a-black, DREDGE5. That's 2-in-a-black, DREDGE5.
I was brought to my knees, but Stinkweed dredged my pipes.
Live from Ravnica, it's the first annual Popper Awards, celebrating excellence in the magical arts. Brought to you by Pauperganda. Our winner for Best Band goes to Cloud of Fairies, which won by a landslide of painful turn two memories. Congratulations and good riddance. Our next award is for Best Flavor Text. There were many great nominees this year, but the poppy goes to Goblin Gardener for his attempt at growing a sausage tree. Our final poppy goes to our Player of the Year. Our winner is Kung Fu Trees. Consistent high tournament placements, as well as creating the new archetype, Delver Red. Congratulations to all our winners.
And we're live. Well, let me see the hand here. Gotta click here. All right, everybody. This is my brother, Donald. We call him the Chalk Boss. I've got Burn queued up, but if somebody wants to challenge him, I was thinking this would be the easiest for him to understand. Again, he's never played, so take it easy.
Not true. You guys, you know, need any lessons, let me know.
That's the spirit. So yeah, let me take you through real quick. So Burn is all about, or we don't have many creatures, but this is your mana. This is what you pay for spells with. And then, see, they're all chiming in. Burn should be a fun one, says Mike Man. So these are, these are lands. It's pretty much lightning bolt, lightning bolt, lightning bolt. Yeah, a little fight. All right, thanks for that, buddy. So he usually plays Burn, so maybe we'll have a nice quick one here. So I'll scroll down and do this for you. There it is. Except, gotta move this. This couldn't be a... Hey, you couldn't do any worse than I did.
I'm good at punching in the face.
I went 0-2 live. Just a big loser. All right, so here we're going to go like this. All right, hand on the mouse. It's all you know. All
right.
So don't let me down. So now he's got 20 life. You got 20 life.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now what?
I think he won the dice roll.
Okay, so he gets to play.
Yeah, so I think it'll be his. Don't take forever, little fight, because it's going to take forever on this side. Don't want to put people to sleep here. All right.
You'd figure
so this is magic. You stare at a screen and look at the number 20.
You'd figure I'd know how to play magic with Deluxicoff as my brother, but that just never happened.
Yeah, his son knows pretty well, a guitarist guru, but Chris, what's going on? This is bad TV. All right, there we go. Okay, so we've got three lands. So say keep. Or it says keep.
Where's that? All right. Okay.
All right. So he's going to go first. So we're just going to hit F6 and just watch what he does. So you got 20 life. He's got 20. We're trying to get that down to zero. All right. So this is all about hitting that okay button a lot. Don't do it all the time, but hit it now.
Okay.
You can do stuff during this turn. All right, now, click one of these mountains right there. And I'd say we'll pass the turn. We learned our lesson from the last few times. So it's blue against red. You're kind of the war color, all about damage and stuff.
Okay.
It's all about, click the No. Well, just hit okay. Teach him how to play burn badly. How's that, everybody? So it looks like... All right. He's playing a creature. It's for one. Okay. And that's all there is to it. So hit okay. Now click on your mountain. This is the one that's out. There we go. Now right click on the cave and then say cycling.
Okay.
That'll just draw us a card and it'll be our turn now. So hit okay. It's a game of okays.
All right.
Drop this. Click both of these. That's how you pay for the spell. See how it costs two. And you click here and click his face. And then click on the creature here. That's a little 1-2 punch. It does three to both. Like, zzz. Red's just passion.
Yeah, see how fury. I did that?
See, now if you quit now, you've never even been attacked by a creature successfully. So hit okay. See? Yeah, interface sucks, they say, but you get used to it. Yeah, this program, everybody loves it, but they hate no matter what they do here. So click face. Yeah, I was going to say you guys could train him how to play, but the delay would make it for a really bad, so I'm just going to be his little demonic tutor on his shoulder. He's been fond of... hit okay. He's been fond of a lot of the magic words like spore cloud. He's always like... Yeah, just click there. What's another one of your favorites? Vampiric?
Oh, vampiric, yeah. Love vampiric.
Sometimes I'll talk to him and you know, I'm so magic friendly, I'll let a word slip like that and say, oh yeah, it's a vampiric quality to that person, and he's like, what are you talking about, and starts laughing and makes for good jokes. Is that all right?
Okay.
All right, so now put that land down, the new one.
This one?
Yeah, it's like your monies.
Okay.
So double,
lots of monies.
Double click the click two and put that archer out.
This guy.
Yeah.
Okay. Right
now, and click that last red.
So we're hitting them with that.
Well, we will. It's sick when they first come out.
Oh,
so
this
click,
one.
Yeah, click that, and then use this one, and target that dude. No, that one. Oh, he almost killed his own archer.
Sounds about right.
Hold on, let me see that.
Kill myself.
So we right click here. We can always say. So anytime there's a spell that happens, this lady's like, fook, fook, and just starts shooting stuff. So
yeah.
We almost roasted ourselves. Go ahead, hit okay.
Stay above the line.
So I'm pretty sure this the deck Little Fight's playing really relies on its creatures getting through once. So we're trying to just roast them out as much as possible.
Barney.
I
know,
Barney
know all about Barneys. It was my nickname when I was a kid.
Yeehaw. Yeah, Donald and I are fond of playing a game we call Deluxe, actually. It uses Uno cards, and it's just crazy advanced, complicated for the sake of being complicated version of the game. Often taking, what, 3 or 4 hours?
Yeah, so we turn a 10-minute game into an hour. Make people leave in a fit of rage. So.
All right. So now it's your turn. So hit okay.
Okay.
Now he's got a shadow creature out. So click the land there.
Yep.
Yep. All right. Bring out the lady again, the archer.
So.
Double click.
I have to.
Yeah. Two. Says, yeah. One has to be red, and one has to be anything.
Okay.
So click. No. Yeah. Just getting you so nervous, poor guy. Now click on the remaining two. And then you're going to put that curse down. See the curse? That rage.
Third oh, one. Yeah. And nice.
It's going to ask you which player. Now, don't choose yourself, or you're going to hurt yourself. So click on Chris's face, 16 up there. And so... Now every turn, let me see this real quick again. Right click on these and oops. All right, there you go. All you. So every single turn, it's going to do one damage to him. Just ding, ding. We can't read your message, little. Write it in Twitch. So we're gonna.
Click on face. Just,
when appropriate, I'm F6ing ourselves so that we can avoid the craziness. See, now the joke is if you win this one, then you did better than I did today. All right, so hold on. We're going to right-click on the ability and then choose that first one, always yield to it. Yeah, and then you never have to worry about it. And it's our curse word of choice. We say we F6 ourselves because it's usually a bad thing. You pass the turn and you totally lose because of it. But so now look, he's at 14, we're at 20. So far we're winning, but it can be deceiving.
Yeah.
Seeing the two of you interact gets me right in the soul hole, says Mike Mann. All these private jokes. Because now we could block that and they'd both die, but that has a thing called shadow, which is like some wicked cool little alter reality. So just hit okay, you're going to take two and he's probably got some trick and it's going to bounce back and we're going to be screwed.
Okay.
So we're still at 20. Let's make a decision. So now he flipped it for this thing, this little ninja.
So there's no chance of him going easy on me. with you hovering over my shoulder.
We'll be all right. Actually, if we stay off of creatures, we might actually have a bit of a plan here. All right, so hit OK. It's your turn again.
Okay.
Now the interface doesn't make it too obvious. Okay, so let's light him up. Drop the archer again. You can click on it first if you want, and then it'll tell you what to pay. It's like two. One has to be red, and all we have is red. So go ahead and get two. There you go. You're getting this. Got it. All right. All right. So now click on one red. See that one called Lava Spike? It's got to be untapped. When they're tapped, it shows they're being like used or paid for. No, no, no. The other one. The first one. Very first one.
Boy. It's having a hard time seeing.
Yeah,
those.
It's this perfect storm of errors possible too, guys, because my brother doesn't have the best eyesight. So and it's far away from him the way I've got the camera
and I
set
don't,
up.
And I don't know the cards.
Yeah. And they are hard to read if I think about it. So click on his face again.
Okay.
Then click on
one more.
Yep. And then the archer already hit him for one, hit okay.
Okay.
So now you've got him half dead. Right. Now we're gonna go for broke here. Watch this. Click on the red again. Sure, you can do that. Yeah, click on his face again. Gonna hit him right in the soul hole. All right, click pay for it. Normally that only does three, but that archer does an extra one. So check this out. So hit okay. So it'll be the. Now the dreaded blue light up. You might have a counter spell.
Is this
so right click on Fire Blast, that card in your hand. And then the second option will say cast by hacking two mountains. Do that. And click on his face again. Then click on two mountains. And you sacrifice instead of pay for. Red's all about passion and rage. You got to click two different ones.
Oh.
There you go. One more. No, you keep getting the same one. When they're green, it highlights. I know it's not easy. Scoot over just a little bit and shoot another one. There you go. Pop! So that does. So he's at one now. Now right-click on, hit OK. All right, now right-click on Fire Blast and do it again. And I think we got this game. Cast by sacking. Click on his face, not on you.
Right.
And then click on the both mountains. And then zap! So the lady's going to kill him before the spell does. Let's see. Because this way, even if he's got a dispel, we got him. It's going to be cool if you win because you can say you've never lost a game of magic. You'll be like, screw my brother. He doesn't know jack shit. He's like, I've never lost.
Deluxikoff, screw that guy.
All right, so hit begin sideboarding. That's going to be pretty funny, man. You do have to retire after this. All right, let me see this real quick. All right, so he's got a lot of 1-1. Here's a word you'd like. Electricery. I'm going to lose a lot of my originality points. You're going to be like, oh, that's where you get that from. All right. Now, Archer was pretty cool, but I don't know. Let's see. What am I playing this for? All right. We'll get rid of two of these. Playing extra lands in this build for that. So that's pretty good. Pretty good. We'll bring in two of these.
Yeah, you're right, Mike, man. I'm going to retire now.
It's over. Yeah, man. Game over.
Yep. Undefeated.
runs in the blood. All right, so we're ready.
All right, so I gotta call Maskell.
I know. Yeah, we'll call it. Well, hopefully you'll retire after this one, and I'll play somebody one round of Rallygon and then call it a day.
Damn, game over.
Interface just keeps folding up here. God damn it. See what I got to deal with live all the time?
Yeah.
Choose yourself, he said. All right. So here we go. Hand up. Yeah, if you start losing, I'll step in, and then we can say you've never lost a game. So we want to hold on. We don't like this hand because we can't pay for anything. So hit mulligan. It means we take in the white box over there. Okay, mulligan.
Get a reload.
Right. This is all right. Better say keep.
Yeah.
Careful. Lost many a game. Yeah. Okay, so click on that card, right click, and just say put on top. There we go, because that's what we're going to draw next. And then we'll go F6 ourselves and see what he's got. Don't click those. So many little things. All right. Sup, cough bro, says Killer Toe. Yeah, if you're just joining us, my brother's never
Junior,
played.
Junior cough.
All right, hold on. Oh, here we go. All right, so click on the mountain again.
Okay.
Now we're just going to F6 ourselves. Keep moving. Wait a little bit here.
So right, we okay. have to build them up? Or?
Yeah, it's kind of a tempo thing. I'm not the best burn player. I get a little too impatient. But so he throws out an axe. It doesn't do anything without a creature, so hit okay. It does give him a little bit quicker clock. Hit okay. This is the end of his turn. Now click on your land, and then right-click on the cave, and then say cycle. Those are lands that are slow, but they're really good. Cycling means you just draw another card, so hit okay. Now it's going to be your turn. Hit okay. Game of okay, they should have called it that, right?
Yeah.
Click on the mountain.
Another one?
Yep. And then cast that lady right there. Nope. The Firebrand Archer. So it tells you to just pay both. Just there we go. Out she comes. We're set.
I don't have to hit his face.
Well, you can't. Creatures, when they come out, they're sick. Unless they say haste. So they're... It just adds a nice balance to the game.
Let him decide. Bad idea.
Semi cough. That'd be pretty cool. Oh no, I got issues. He just snapped our creature. Doesn't kill it, it just bounces us back to their hand. Blue is really good at, you know,
needling.
Yeah, pissing people off. Uh-huh. So hit okay. Now click on your mountain. Get the archer out, screw it. Bring her out again. No. Drop the mountain first. Click on the mountain. There you go. Now play one more. That one's tapped. There you go. For the archer. There we go. So this way, if he's got something. Okay, now wait. Click on this. Pyroblast.
Pyroblast? That's
now
another.
Say counter target blue. The first one. There you go. Now click at the counter spell. Just click on his blue card. There you go. Now click on the red to pay for it, because it costs one. So, I mean, this is the typical example of two wizards clashing. Like, tsh, tsh, tsh. He might have a counter. Yep. Now he says, oh, yeah, counter that unless you pay two. See how we're tapped out?
Mm-hmm.
So we're screwed.
So we need, yeah.
So we just
don't have it.
He wins. I say no.
Okay.
So he wins that war. Our lady dies. So, and it's just your graveyard. That's where all your discard or old spells go. You getting it?
No, not really.
Right to the soul hole, says Killer Tofu. Yeah, should have had Moon Cheese babies queued up.
All right.
Go ahead and hit okay.
Moon Cheese babies?
Yep. Hey, let's do it again. Let's see if he's got it again. Click on the lady again.
Archer.
Yeah.
Sorry. God, what's with her? Just all the time.
She likes you. There's certain cards that seem to just like people. So pay two for it.
Okay.
All right. See if this works. He might be out of counter magic by now. What does this say? It says target player draws a card at the beginning of next turn's upkeep. All right. Not often I have to read a card, but I do with Sapphire Charm. Hit okay. He's targeting himself because he needs options. but he only draws it at the beginning of the next turn. So hit okay. I think this one will stick.
All right. Yeah, this is very schizophrenic.
So we're going to suspend this one. Pay one. All right. And we'll go into that for you. Just save some time. So we're pretty much, I'm just going to have six here, so you don't have to press okay a lot. All right, digital tears for my brother. Think how nerve-wracking this is, playing a game this complicated live. Probably, I'd be sweating bullets, especially with his undefeated record. I had to do a double take on that one. LOL, Sharon. All right, so we, this is a tough one. So click on the rift bolt. Go ahead and say, always yield. Now, do you want to kill him or the creature? I say we nail the creature.
Yeah.
All right, so click on the ninja.
Okay.
Pop. Say okay. It's so weird not clicking because I'm like, is that how it works? Wait, now let me just cast. Because this one is a pain in the butt to cast this. Go from here. Alright, now I hit OK. Drop the lady. And we'll F6 it. There you go. Alright. It's a game of just keep replaying the same damn creature. This deck is playing has big holes in it though. It has no soul. Alright. Designed it drunk, says Little Fight. Hydro blasted.
Sounds about right.
There it is again. All right.
So that's the one we took out.
Yeah. I want you to click on that right where you're at. Click on it. Say cast. Just point to that blue ninja. And pay the one for it. Zap. And then the archer just does her thing. Let me see real quick. I'll set the... You set these just to always work. It's so silly. It's like it's a great always spell, but it's like, do you always want to do this? It's like, of course I do. But you have to tell it to. All right, so he's a 19 with one card. We're not looking too good either, though, so hit okay. You're doing great. You're undefeated. All right, click two mana, and then click on this alchemist. Pretty great.
Alchemist, like
yeah, my brother's the scientist of the family, so he likes the alchemist. All right, so now we're going to say okay. This is going to be your first creature attack, so click on the lady. Wait till I'm waiting on Little Fight here. All right, hold on. Less typing, Little Fight, more playing. All right, so I like this. Hit OK. So now it's turning sideways, so it's hitting for two, so hit OK. And I think, we'll just pass here. So we can really... hopefully light him up next turn with the alchemist and the
semi-cough. Yeah, I like it.
Semi-cough. How do you say
it? It could stick.
All right, hit all right. Actually, I don't think we really have a play here, so I'll just F6 ourselves. MTG Elgato, hey, this is my brother, semi-cough. Playing Magic for the first time ever.
Not a cough.
Not a cough, that sounds pretty good too. All right, hit all right. All right, now, oh man, this is going to get painful. He's got two cards in his hand. First things first, we want to attack. So hit OK. And then we're going to attack with the archer again. The other one can't do it because it has defender.
Helicopter parent mode.
Click on that. Hit all right. All right, keep hitting OK. All right. So now he'll be at 15. Hit OK. There's a lot of opportunities for him to block. Okay, stop. All right, click on the alchemist. Just do it. So he does one to everybody, or to your opponent. Now click on one of these, two of these actually.
Okay.
Bring out the archer.
Okay.
Now click the red, and then needle drop, and then point to his face. This does one now. And let me see it real quick. So this is just a craziness. So that'll do that. This will do this. And then we'll have to tag him again. Zap, pow, bing. And this hits, comes over here. And we'll pass the turn. All right. So now we got him kind of up against it, hopefully.
Love the helicopter parent.
Needle drop for far. Semi-cough, don't screw up the stack. He's never screwed up. He's undefeated. Look, I think he's gonna
perfect.
He's going to retire undefeated all time. I always
champion.
Piss people off at Christmas time if I learn a new game and I win the first time. I'm like, I'm done. Never playing again. Retire undefeated. Oh! All right. Well, everybody say sayonara to my brother.
All right, guys. Enough. Thanks.
And we'll roll the commercial and I'll be back after this.
It was fun.
Problem 3. For this problem, you'll need to set your calculator to maths. It's the future, and Queen Elizabeth III and Queen Elizabeth are going to a party held by Queen Elizabeth V. They're keen to make the right impression, so it's important that they choose their outfits carefully. Queen Elizabeth III has 40 dresses to choose from, whereas Queen Elizabeth IV has 4,000. Queen Elizabeth V has just one dress, but it has the ability to transform itself into the shape of any dress. The night before the party, Queen Elizabeth IV's handmaiden steals the patterns to Queen Elizabeth III's dresses and, working through till dawn, makes 40 exact replicas. Can you calculate the probability that all three queens will be wearing the same dress at the party? And how many times can Queen Elizabeth V's dress change before it overheats? That's the last of your problems. And you now have a few more seconds to finalize all your calculations while the following film plays. Stop fighting.
Magic of Yavamaya. Now in your kitchen. Mutani spaghetti. The only noodles whose power and tastiness are equal only to their legendary ingredients. Our pasta is made from only the finest weather seed, imported from Dominaria straight to your dinner table. Enjoy Mutani spaghetti. Combine it with our signature Raffaello's cheeses and finish it off with a glass of sweet Reshida. Mutani's, the magic of Yavamaya in every bite.
Available at Maras's Market. And we're back. I think everything's in its right spot. Oh my gosh, everything's moving. All right. Okay, so I'll play one more and then we'll call it a day. If anybody wants to challenge up, or I'll just run over to the casual room. I think I'll play Gond and hopefully win once live with it. But thanks for keeping my brother company there and being nice to them all. Thanks. Now I want some spaghetti, says Killer Tofu. Yeah, it always makes me hungry, says Mike Mann. Yeah, pasta's the bane, I tell you. All right, I'm going to run over to the play lobby here. Constructed, tournament practice. Yeah, we're at an hour and a half already, so if I don't see somebody pretty soon, we'll go from there. So let me see. Gone Deluxe. We'll hit play, and hopefully somebody shows up soon. We can at least envelope this turn, but yeah, it's pretty cool. Not many people have an undefeated brother. Never been beaten. We're going to retire undefeated with the highest win percentage in all of Magic history.
Semi-cough.
That's a pretty cool name. We ought to buy you an account and just like, you just put your win percentage up. Be pretty great. All right. This is a nice little hand here. We've got our combo going. Got the guard. Got defense. We'll keep this. See where it goes. Semi-cough. FTW. Yeah, man, I had to listen to him more often. He's 100%. I was 0% today. Oh, what the hell is this? The event has been canceled. Okay, that was weird. Oh, I never seen that happen before. That was strange. All right, here we go with Soul Warden. Looks like we might be able to get revenge against Stompy, unless this is elves. That will suck. But now, see, you can understand how it works, where we've got, you know, the currency you got to pay for every turn. A lot of clicking, though. You don't realize
sometimes on Monday when I go to work, I'm just like, oh, because I've had a long weekend of gaming. And get pretty crazy. This could either be elves or stompy still, because both of them run both these cards. No games for you, says Mike Mann. Soul Warden, Guardian of the Hole. Yeah, a couple months back, somebody said something about a soul hole, and it just became like this private joke that we're always laughing about. Then there's Moon Cheese Babies from Upright Citizens Brigade, which is, you know, that when they were talking, they were, had prejudice against astronauts, and he's like, we don't need no Moon Cheese Babies. And first time I played that, everybody started laughing, so they wanted me to say Moon Cheese Babies whenever I won or something.
That was me. He was trying to play you.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Cancel.
Oh, sorry about that, bud. All right, so we'll bring out the bodyguard. Gain some life, drop the garden. Prismatic Strands might pay some dividends in this game just because he is swinging at us with a 4-4, so. But it'll feel like a 2 with this scenario. Never attack into a Quarian Ranger as they can untap things at instant speed. So we're just going to play hooky here. We got the combo in hand. We need one land. We need one pretty much anything. So if we draw land next turn, it'll probably be a gone play followed by presence. I mean, a guard play followed by presence. I wonder what my brother's thinking right now. He's like, what the? All these words. Craziness. It's kind of like when you go to anybody's new job for the first time, and it just seems so complicated, but you don't realize how much of it's just kind of getting the pattern of clicking OK and that sort of thing.
Click OK until it's not OK.
Yeah, he says click OK until it's not OK. Yeah, green's usually the... I like aggro decks usually. The way this guy's playing, this was one of my very first favorite decks that... But I'm no semi-cough. That's for sure. Well, we don't like to play it naked, but we'll do it. We'll go from here. Drop the guard. And the combo after that. Now, about the only thing he can use to disrupt this is Vines of Vastwood, so hopefully that's not the case. With every creature, you become more my servant. How did the Emperor say it in Return of the Jedi?
Just always play me.
I've been tempted, Mike, man, believe me. Killer Tofu says, don't play control, always yield. Yeah, I'm a far, far way away from playing like a Teachings build live. I'll need like 10 hours and some sedatives and maybe a play from the bathroom, if you get my drift. So I don't have to ever move. That just takes forever. Not my style. We're probably going to be playing some tennis later, which is another game my brother beats me at. He's Magic being the top one, 100%. All right, joke's getting old, I guess. Kobolds, on the other hand, says, yeah, Killer Tofu's always getting me to play Kobold combo. All right, so we don't want him to untap that forest. Well, right click. So this lady right here is pretty awesome. Call her the Soul Sisters or the Soul Hole. Every time a creature is cast, you gain a life, which is just really disheartening for your opponent. Because so we'll check out this combo, bro. So we pay green, anything, and a white, and we put this on this. So whenever this creature comes into play, this untaps, which is its special ability. And then this enchantment says whenever you tap it, you get a creature. So check this out. Create a creature. Which this normally is supposed to happen once with a normal thing. This is what you call a combo. In the I'm explaining to my brother off camera if you're just joining us. So we just make infinite creatures and infinite life. And usually people submit it about this point, but I don't think our opponent is doing that. All right. And each time we're doing this, we're gaining a life because of the Soul Hole Sister. And this game does have sound effects. I just turn them off so that it doesn't irritate people that are playing in the background or things like that. So, yeah, usually at about the fourth or fifth one, they kind of get it, and they're like, oh, I don't think I can answer that. Their natural state's a good answer for Stompy with this, though. The second it enchants, you can only get one activation out of it, and for one green, you save the day. Need a soul hole sound effect, says Killer Tofu. Yes. Well, thanks to Little Fight for finding that commercial from the 90s. That was the goods. Oh, no. Do we got a quitter? What's this guy doing? Just hanging out. See, so on his end right now, it says okay. And he's not doing nothing, but sometimes you get rage quitters. Ah, this damn interface just blinking all over the place.
Oh, he just gave up?
No. He's just making us do everything, so extra spot in hell for people like that. Unless it's me. Alright, I'll put this sign over here. Yes. I already said stack abilities automatically. Let's go. See how many, each of these is a 1-1. Now I've got 10 of them. See my life going up each time. And so you just kind of, I think he quit here because it grayed out here. Unless we timed out or something. Hello. Oh, okay, so he quit. So that's usually how a game goes against Stompy. But we do like Journey to Nowhere's against him to bring that back through. Standard Bear is really good. Just like the flag, like, hey, look over here. That's totally what the card does. Just makes you pull off. All right, I'll take out Ascends. I really like Prismatic in this matchup. I think I'm just going to keep it to that. I'll lose one presence and bring in a ring. And we'll see how this does. Hello, Into the River. Thank you for joining us. I think that's your first time chiming in. All right. Get him some vitamin D. Wait. Thank God at least some game league comes by once in a while to get him some vitamin D. Hey, he's saying I never get out of the house. I do plenty of time at night or really early in the morning. Little Fight's the sun lover, and he's always giving me hell for not enjoying the cancer ball. All right. So we've got the goods against him. We'll keep this. Not the best hand, but if he doesn't have removal, the Standard Bearer can really do some damage here. Welcome to the fold, says Killer Tofu. Yeah, Into the River. We had a really rare show today where my brother's here from out of town, and we were teaching him how to play last game. So Semikoff, we call him. But he went 2-0, and he's undefeated, and he's retiring forever, so he's the most most decorated Magic player of all time. And he's related to me. Hear, hear. Now that's, it's fun seeing my brother see this community, because we kind of were of the same mind when I was talking to him about starting a Twitch feed, and it was like, what's the point? People watching you play a game and blah, blah, blah. But now he's kind of getting it. It's about the community and seeing people from all over the world just kind of all getting together and enjoying this game we all love. All right. I'm going to do this now. And if he's got gut shot, he's got it. Otherwise, I'll get the life going next turn, because I don't like seeing an Eldrazi spawn. There's another good word for you. With the Hunger of the Hell Pack backup. Hopefully he's got 3 or 4 dead cards. Truly, he probably just has an epic confrontation and he's going to smash face with it. But we got beers downstairs if you want to go crack one.
I'm all right.
All right.
Yeah, I'll wait.
And after last night, we had a pretty epic hydroblasted fest. Just a bunch of two boring old men sitting around. But hey, it's the company you're with, right? Bring me a beer, says Mike Mann, 1998. Better win white than Don Winkle. That's right. All right. Let's go Soul Hole. And then I respect the life. I think I might... Yeah, we'll get our mana right. Keep moving. Really like to grab a Sens Enlistment or something right about now. Or what's the other little lady gonna do? Ooh, Enchant Creature. I haven't seen people play Horned Helm and Stompy before. Horned Helm costs 2. Says equipped creature gets +1/+1 and has trample, and you can do it instantly for 2 green. Sounds pretty cool. But normal equipped is just 1. Helpful to read that to people, because sometimes they're looking at a little screen and they don't know what they're seeing either. So Stompy's really good at tricking out its creatures and making them huge, so this Flag Bearer stops all that from happening, unless he kills it. So he's got Miles, so D and I can do a show from his place. Yes. Bring Semikoff around for tonight. Let's have more beers. Litified is down. Hey, maybe. All right. Hey, better lucky than good. Look at this. Battle Screech. Yeah, everybody from the 80s or kids of the 80s, remember Battle Beasts? It was right around the time Transformers was out. I was like, wood, fire beats wood. And then the song would be all, Battle Beasts. I don't know if there's a commercial there, but for some reason I was just reminded of that. All right, we'll do this. Need more spice. It's a little fight. So we attack through the air usually with this deck. This deck's a lot like Jeet Kune Do from Bruce Lee, where it's just like it can strike low, strike high, strike round. Any UFC fans out there, you guys excited for the fight tomorrow night? Brother and I are getting amped up for it. might actually brave a public bar to go. It's pretty, gets pretty pricey. Ooh, boy, I'm tempted to block that. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hey, man. Let's, yeah, I'll let it through. F6 myself. Oh, yeah, getting that one, says Mike, man. Who you got, John Jones or Cormier for the main event? My brother saw Cyborg for the first time and was like, the hell is that? I felt so bad for her. She is pretty manly looking. All right. We'll drop the garrison and play possum here. Bring him back in like we need our little life dudes. And I want to just block like crazy. We're going to have two for that, one for that. I'm just going to attack with one of our dudes here. And I'll show you one of my favorite cards, brother. Prismatic Strands. It's you prevent, see how these are all green creatures? Mm-hmm. It prevents all damage of the color of your choice. So I block everything, which would normally be a bad idea. And then I say, hey, guess what? I get to only punch you and you can't punch me in the face. Yeah, she looks rough, says Mike, man. Mm-hmm. Right in the soul hole, into the river, says a twisted abomination. Kershaw was great. Well, you got Little Fight to thanks for that. I would have never found that. My internet comedy knowledge only goes so deep. So if you got any cool skits that you can see it being a card, a little tongue-in-cheek, Popper love, let us know, popperganda@gmail.com, and always makes the show a little bit better that way. So he's Vines of Vast Wooding, our standard bearer. Maybe a frustration play here. Oh, it's to untap the Nettle Sentinel. That's cool. All right. Almost done here. I'm going to roll to another commercial or two after this, and then we'll call it a day. But for people like Into the River that haven't seen any of this stuff, check out our YouTube. Shiraz, maybe you can bring up the link for that. We got a ton of videos and good stuff out there, and they get kind of lost in the shuffle unless you attend us live. So if you're new to Pauperganda, definitely don't miss out on that. So we are going to block like crazy. We almost did a going crazy David Lee Roth style promo today because it's kind of a private joke with my brother and I. We love that song, even as cheesy as it is. We didn't really like it when it was live. I mean, we didn't dislike it, but that's become kind of a theme for when we get together. I think she took away whipping from the ugly stick before entering the ring. Yowza. Yeah, I wouldn't say that to her face. I've trained quite a bit in MMA, but man, some of those ladies, they are pretty formidable. Actually, the lady I would like to fight least is probably Joanna Jojacek from Poland. Even though she's small, my God, that woman is just a beast. It's like a Gatling gun. She's like the Thermo Alchemist. Just pop, 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 pop. So we're going to call green. Nothing going down. Everything having a good old time. That's a kind of a neat play. Extra mana. Interesting tech, Horned Helm. But no damage happens. All right. So we've already got that live in our graveyard. We're going to drop this. We've got the combo in hand. We'll drop Midnight Guard here. We'll play Midnight Guard. Gain some life. We've got Prismatic in the yard, so that's kind of a daunting feat. We'll drop the Sands. And let's see. I'll attack with these guys. See what's going down. Miss Gina Carano. Yeah, that's right. That is her name. Paul Dyson. I walk in and Horned Helm. Yeah, it was a very weird show today. I only played two rounds live. I lost them both. The three I didn't play, I won all of them. And then my brother steps in and we coach him on how to play Magic. And he goes undefeated and then retires undefeated. So it's kind of been a little tongue-in-cheek fun day here. Getting ready to go out ourselves in a little bit. Watch my littlest do his parkour and go eavesdrop at the SpaceX facilities. I like to gently trespass there and act like we're these big brains and look at the rockets they're always working on. It's very cool. It's very neat living really close to SpaceX headquarters. Pretty awesome humans, man. Elon Musk should be, heck with president, he should be like emperor of the earth. Guys like Tesla Part 2, I love him. Just don't send it to the aliens, please. What are we talking about here? The Horned Helm doesn't seem that terrible and stompy, said Shiraz. Yeah, it's I think we're seeing it in its optimal scenario where you've got a little bit of a flood issue and you know, being able to ping pong it back and forth. But it does cost two. So, but yeah, there's worse cards, that's for sure. So he's going to hit us for three. And even if he has vines, the standard bearer is going to keep it from hitting Our Lady. So I think this is going to do it, unless there's some crazy trick I don't know about. Presence of Gonda is live. I'll show them the goods. Here comes the fun and a concession. Alrighty. Well, that's normally how this deck plays out. I'll go over the deck list here because this is my baby. It's not often that you make a deck that, you know, it's most people make a rogue deck, go to a few outings, and then have a 5-0 here or there or whatever. But this one, thanks to Methonical playing it so often and playing it so well, it's really done well. So I'll go over the list here real quick, and then we're going to call it a day. Software is acting a little bit funky here. Hold on a minute. Gond Deluxe. So the original Gond looked like this. This is the standard, and this has a little bit of tweaks on mine, but it's all white green. There's a lot of green creatures. Let me bring up the cards here so we can all see them better. It still runs Presence and Midnight, the same thing, but you know, very different card set. It runs Sprout, Swarms, the Angels. You guys have all seen this before. And outside of a few times, it hasn't really placed all that well. It used the Pallid Mycoderm to kind of shut the door on opponents, scatter the seeds, and different varieties of how often they would use that. But what I'd like to do with this deck, and what my initial intent was to steer it more towards white so I could turn on Prismatic Strands. And when Commune with the Gods came up, which finds the two pieces that you need, a creature and an enchantment, but you have collateral damage and that you're throwing cards away. But what I like about that is when we're throwing cards away, we can flash them back with cards like the all-powerful, Prismatic Strands, Rally the Peasants, even Battle Screech, Sen's Enlistment, and making it a lot more, and I overuse the word organic in this build, but making it a lot more organic to the list there. So this, the curve on this, I know the lands look all over the place, and it's about 99% of where it was when I had it, but Methonical definitely improved it, losing one garden, adding a crag, and then I put these two in over the Holdout Settlement, which is just a superior card for the artwork and for the desert bonus, which going into the future, I think that might be a real thing. But anyway, guys, I'll have the list in the description, but it's not that big of a secret. Methonical has been placing pretty regularly with it and such. But if you're squeamish, my brother raised me on horror. You've all known that for a while now, all the stories about the little lake and stuff. But so this is kind of an homage to him. This whole, all the commercials and stuff are kind of little private jokes with him and I. But so this next one is a fake B-movie horror trailer. Anybody watches us all the time knows about it, so it's no big deal. But if you're a little squeamish, you probably want to look away right about now. Anyway, we'll see you next week on Pauperganda or sooner. I still got all next week off, but family's in town, so I'll be here and there. Anyway, guys, send any questions, comments, concerns at pauperganda@gmail.com, and we will see you later.
Get swamped with horror as Pauperganda Studios presents all the classic horror films from the legendary Bojuka brothers. First, the 70s masterpiece, Howl from Beyond. Then, the fan favorite, The Faceless Butcher. Plus, the cult classic, Undying Evil. Followed by non-stop horror like Innocent Blood, Grim Harvest, Bloodseeker, Evil Presence, Twisted Abomination, and more. Murderous Mayhem Marathon, Rakdos style. Tourney's Pauperganda's horror gore galore. Coming soon.
Attention, Pauperganda Knights, show your love of all things Papa with our ultra deluxe playmats. And true to our Papa roots, the glorious artwork is 100% free.
Trying to give these guys everything they can get to me. That's it.
just send an email to pauperganda@gmail.com with the subject 1, 2, or 3, and we'll send you the playmat file for free.
I gotta read it again because my mind is just a piece of shit this morning.
All you need to do is visit our friends at geekgaming.com.